people of Mars. This is Bernice Summerfield, broadcasting on them, hopefully on an emergency frequency. I'm trapped in a pyramid. Yes, a pyramid. Roughly 4 kilometers southeast of Colony Sector 5. My guide's dead, killed by... Look, all you need to know is that Egyptian gods were real. They came from Phaistor Osiris, had terrible powers. And Sutekh, the nastiest of the lot, has just come back to life in the middle of your war. Hello? Anyone? Got a death heading your way. Stop fighting. Send help. Because the only man who can help is...
Hi everyone, TardisSky123 here, and today I'm going to be reviewing Doctor Who, The New Adventures of Bernice Summerfield, Volume 2, The Triumph of Sutekh. But before I go for that, I just want to quickly mention the news from Big Finish that came out yesterday about new series stuff and whatnot with River Song. Quite exciting news, I guess. I'll go more in depth on that with the review of The Sun Makers later today. But for now, let's just focus on this. Which is Big Finish Rip Nightmare, starring Sylvester McCoy as the Seventh Doctor, Lisa Bowerman as Bernice Summerfield, Sophie Aldridge as Ace, and Gabriel Wolfe as Sutekh. It's quite an exciting cover there, and then if I put that in, there is your spine. Doctor Who, New Adventures of Bernice Summerfield, got a picture of the TARDIS there, and then we've got Volume 2, Triumph of Sutekh written there. The 4 stories included, and Big Finish, We Love Stories, written up, which is interesting. Usually you have just Big Finish written on the side. Maybe this is what the standard going forward, so you'll have this Doom Coalition as well, I'm assuming. And also you've got, you don't have the number 2 written there as second in the series, presumably because it is Volume 2 written right under the TARDIS bit there. So let's take a look on the side here. Once again, the stories, the Pyramid of Sutekh, by Guy Adams, The Vaults of Osiris by Justin Richards, The Eye of Horus by James Goss, and The Tears of Isis by Una McCormack. You may notice a pattern with those titles, but anyway. Then on the bottom here, we have that standard stuff there, nothing particularly interesting. And then on the top, slightly more interesting, but still nothing overly interesting. So now let's take a look at the stories themselves. And starting off is The Pyramid of Sutekh, written by Guy Adams. This is 2.1 written there, starring Sylvester McCoy, Lisa Bowerman, Sophie Aldred, with Gabriel Wolfe and Sutekh. Same stuff as written on the front. Brand new adventures, broadcast audio drama. You've got a nice picture of Sylvester McCoy there with the Pyramid of Sutekh in the background there, set on Mars. Forecast audio drama written on the side there. Interesting that there's not a picture of Sylvester McCoy for that title sequence here. They've done this a bit differently. I think they did this the same with their first release as well, where they've gone slightly different, just to kind of distinguish it from the main Seventh Doctor stories, because it's also mainly focusing on Bernice Summerfield rather than just the Doctor. Then on the spine here you have that bit again. Once again, no Sylvester McCoy head there to distinguish it from Seventh Doctor Rangers, I'm assuming. And on the back here you have your fairly small cast, as well as directed by Scott Hancock, and a very small blurb there. Taking a look on the inside now, we have the production credits there, and the disc out. You have an advertisement for the first release, Volume 1, and back in here. Now let's take a look at the booklet. You have the front of your booklet, and then on the inside, nothing too interesting. Writer's notes, there's writer's notes in each of these, as well as some images. Got a nice image there of Gabriel Wolfe with a little toy suit. And now let's put that back away and talk about the story itself. What did I think of The Pyramid of Sutekh? Well, I thought it was an interesting start. Nothing overly spectacular. I've heard some people say very positive things about this. and I guess it is quite a fun start. The Doctor isn't quite himself, and Bernice Summerfield very much carries this whole thing with another character, kind of. They've got a double act there. Can't really mention that character, though, but it is quite fun. But it's mainly just a two-hander between Bernice Summerfield and that other character. Do have some other scenes with the Doctor and whatnot, but it is mostly Bernice Summerfield all the way through this, which is very good because Lisa Bowman is amazing as Bernice Summerfield. She really does do a good job carrying this story. I don't think many other companions could carry a story like this, but she does. And what's also good about this is that she's flawed as well. She's upset at times by this whole thing. You really get the feeling that she's out of her depth facing Sutekh, who is practically a god. And you know, you don't get the feeling that she's just taking it in her stride. You do get that feeling that she's upset, but she's pushing forward anyway. And that's more strong character trait than it would be if she was just kind of like pushing forward, just like, oh, another day in the TARDIS or whatever. It is very much shown that she is out of her depth here, but she's trying anyway. And that really does show a strong character on her part. So I think this whole box set kind of like juggles with that idea a bit. It's mainly this one which really does put that to the test. Do have some fun references back to the Pyramids of Mars, but for the most part it does stand on its own fairly well. So, and there are some interesting bits of continuity in there as well. A bit of a link to a Virgin New Adventure, I've forgotten the name of it now, Lung Barrow, that's it. Some might not like that little reference, but it's not too much of a reference. I won't say what it is. Those of you who listen to it will probably know what I'm on about here. It is slightly different. It doesn't canonise Lung Barrow, but it does sort of reference an idea from Lung Barrow. So that's that. What else is there in this story? It is kind of like a bit of an action adventure at the start. There is a certain character at the start who doesn't really make much of an impression, and I was going to say something about him, but I've decided better of it actually. I think I'll leave that to you, even though it won't be much of a spoiler. But anyway, yeah, Sylvester McCoy does a good job in this. I feel when he's doing kind of like that strange, unsettling stuff, which I won't go into why he's doing that stuff. Some of you may have guessed it already, and some of you will know from listening to it. But I feel that Sylvester McCoy could do a better job with that. It does kind of get a bit comical there, which is unfortunate. But there are times when he does it really well, and times when it turns into a bit too comical when it's supposed to be seriously, unfortunately. But yeah, that is the Pyramid of Sutekh. I would rate it an 8 out of 10. So now, let's take a look at the next story in the box set, which is The Vaults of Osiris. So you've got Doctor Who, New Adventures, Bernice Summerfield, all the standard stuff there, written by Justin Richards. You have Ace there with the Eye of Horus in the background. Brand New Adventures, full cast audio drama, starring Sylvester McCoy, Lisa Bowman, and Sophie Aldred, and full cast audio drama once again written on the side there. Same spine really, except obviously The Vault of Osiris written on the side. And then on the back here, once again, pretty much the same standard stuff that you'd expect. Inside, no production notes this time, instead it's just that quite nice image there. Then behind this, you have a Bernice Summerfield box set. So let's put that back there. And take a look on the inside of the booklet. Writer's notes from Justin Richards this time, and another image right there. So then, what did I think of The Vaults of Osiris? This is very much kind of like a two-hander between Ace and Bernice Summerfield. This is kind of like, this is the story which Ace preaches most prominently in, and if you're an Ace fan, then you will probably enjoy the story quite a lot. There is kind of like that idea that kind of like comes along later. This is set quite late in her timeline. I won't go too much in depth as to why, but she is kind of like going about with a gun in this, which, I don't know, it's not that it doesn't really fit her character. I just feel it's a bit too domestic, like bringing a gun into this. You know, Nitro 9, of course, fine. I don't know why I'm fine with explosives, but I'm not fine with Ace running around with a gun. It just feels a bit too crude and simple for her character, maybe. I'm not sure, but yeah, not overly fond of that aspect of her. But other than that, she's pretty much the same Ace we know and love in this. And there is a lot of fun to be had between her and Lee Spellman. There's a specific joke in there, which I won't spoil for you, but it's kind of like a play on words with Ace's name that Benny makes, and that is quite a funny little scene there. And, you know, there's kind of like light-hearted moments in this. It's probably the most light-hearted of the stories, but it is serious as well. And it's the Doctor Light one, which is fine, because the Doctor's got like... it is in the style of the New Adventures novels, where the Doctor kind of drifts into the background. It's kind of like manipulating everything. So this box set very much takes that aspect and placed that a lot here. So that's the reason why he's in the background of this. He's got like plotting and whatnot. And there are other reasons as well, which I won't get into because that will spoil it for you. But yeah, the Vault of Osiris. There is a lot of filler in this. I will say this is probably the filler episode where not much is really going on. It's a very simple episode. It's just going from point A to point B. But despite having said all that, this is the most fun I had with the box set, honestly. I did have loads of fun with this story. And that is why I'm going to rate it a 9.5 out of 10, I think. Because it's just a lot of fun, really. So that's what we've got to say about the Vault of Osiris. And now we will take a look at the Eye of Horus. So yeah, and there you have Lee Spellman as Benny. And got the Eye of Horus in the background there. It's in the physical object, the Eye of Horus. Whereas one here was just the symbol, the hieroglyph. But anyway, Brand New Adventures, full cast audio drama, Doctor Who, The New Adventures of Bernice Summerfield, The Eye of Horus by James Goss, 2.3, starring Sylvester McCoy, Lisa Bauman, Sophie Aldred, with Gabriel Wolfe as Sutekh. Here's your spine there. Take a look on the back. Bigger cast for this one, and there's your blurb. On the inside, we have same standard stuff there. I'll take this away. You have other Doctor Who releases which feature Bernice Summerfield. And then we have the inside of the booklet, if I can just get that out. And there you have the inside of that, with writer's notes from James Goss this time. Such a shock. So now if I just put that away. So then, the Eye of Horus. This is kind of like the story set in ancient Egypt. You kind of like have to have an episode set there when it's all about Egyptian mythology and whatnot. So yeah, this is kind of like that story. And it's very much kind of like Bernice Summerfield in ancient Egypt trying to work out what's going on here. And yeah, it's the longest story in the set. And there is some interesting stuff. It's kind of like going back into history. You have kind of historical stuff there, but it's not kind of like purely historical. There are loads of sci-fi elements in there as well, but it's very much character based for the most part, until especially in the first half. It's just kind of like characters interacting, which is quite good and quite a lot of fun, I feel. And there are kind of like, I wouldn't say adult themes, I wouldn't really call alcohol an adult theme, but it's very much kind of like a new adventure thing. It's something that the new series wouldn't really go into, but here, not the new series, well, I don't know, I'm not sure whether the new series has delved into that too much, but it's kind of like a theme represented here for the first half, and it's not something the classic series would have done, but it's something that the new adventures would have embraced. So yeah, I may be making a bigger deal of that than it actually is. It's just present, really. It's not really a theme that's dealt with. It's just something that's there to make it feel more real. So yeah, overall, the Eye of Horus is a good story. It's kind of like, not necessarily a calm before the storm, I wouldn't really call this calm, but is very much a bit more of a character piece, especially for the Doctor as well, who's once again acting a bit off in this story. But it is a very interesting story, and very much building up to the final part. So I would give this one an 8.5, because it's not necessarily fun in kind of like the typical sense, but it is enjoyable, and it is quite dark in places as well. So now that we have done those three, let us move on to the final part, the Tears of Isis. So Doctor Who, New Adventures of Bernice Summerfield, blah 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 blah. Sutekh this time in the little bubble thing, and then you have starring Sylvester McCoy, Lisa Bowman, Sophie Aldred, with Gabriel Wolfe as Sutekh. There's your spine, standard stuff. There's your back, standard stuff. Take a look on the inside. A little bit different this time, because there's two discs. Obviously, you've got this first disc here, Tears of Isis, and the second disc here, the bonus disc. And then we've got an advertisement for the upcoming novel adaptations. So let's put that there. And now let's take a look on the inside once again. And you probably know what to expect. It is another set of writer's notes from Una McCormack this time. So let's slide that back in there and talk about the grand finale to the Triumph of Sutekh. Yeah, I'm not overly fond of this story, I will have to say. It is quite a jarring one for me. Mainly, it's an okay story by itself, but it just feels like a lot of it is padding once again. A lot of the events do happen in this with Bernice Summerfield are rather inconsequential when you reach the end of it, which is slightly disappointing, but they are fun moments nonetheless, and some quite dark moments as well. It's very strong moments. Kind of like characters interacting again for the most part. The idea that what would these people do, these cultists, who are kind of like worshipping the end of the world, to kind of like say it's going to happen. What would they do if it actually happened? Would they kind of like go, oh yeah, we predicted this, or would they kind of like go, oh gosh, this actually happened? And this very much plays to that idea quite nicely, and I do like that element to it. That is a very strong way, direction to go with this story. And I think Una McCormack did a good job there. However, in resolving the overall theme, the resolution does feel very weak and leaves a lot of questions as to how. And obviously I won't talk about that too much, because that will spoil it. But it's quite jarring, and I'm not sure how that works precisely. I can't say why I think that, because once again that would spoil it, but it's just doesn't make much sense to me, to be honest. And it's sort of like a new series thing involving time travel, where it's okay at first, but you start to think about it and chip away at it, and suddenly the whole thing falls apart. And I have listened to this twice, and it still confused me a little less on the second listen, but at the same time I'm still not sure that holds water, that idea. But you know, Tears of Isis, if you move beyond that whole thing probably colours this whole story for me, which is unfortunate, because there is some enjoyable stuff moving up to it. Once again, Lisa Bowman takes centre stage while the Doctor kind of like snoops off into the background, and you know, the Doctor is miserable in this, and he's rather unbearable for the whole story, to be honest. I mean, this story made me not look down on Sylvester McCoy's Doctor, but kind of like made me think, that's a bit, not dark, but just annoying. His character is quite annoying in this story on the first listen. On the second listen, when I knew what he was up to, I kind of like accepted his character a bit more. Kind of like thought, oh, well, it's all part of the plan. But at the same time, you know, on that first listen, he was an annoying character, I will say that. He's kind of like the complaining character who, like, no one likes in a story, and who the Doctor himself will often just kind of like tell to grow a backbone, really. But yeah, it's one of those situations where I can't go too in-depth, because that would spoil it. But overall, The Tears of Isis, it has a lot of fun to be had. Resolution doesn't really work too well, in my opinion, but overall, antiquities by Sis, I would give a 7.5 out of 10. So let's take this away and overview the entire box. So here we have the box complete here, and now for my thoughts on it as an overall. It's one of those cases where the whole isn't as much as the sum of its parts. I will say, I do enjoy the individual stories more than I would the overall thing, and once again, that's down to that resolution, kind of. Would I say it's a bad box set? No, I definitely would not. Would I say it's kind of disappointing as an overall? Yes, I would, because of that resolution, unfortunately. That resolution really does colour the whole thing for me. But I did enjoy myself much more on the second listen. I kind of like got over that disappointing ending bit and made sense with some bits. Maybe a third listen I will actually understand what's going on here. But at the same time, The New Adventures of Bernice Summerfield Volume 2, The Triumph of Sutekh, there is a lot of fun to be had with this if you don't look into that conclusion too much. There are some very nice characters, and Bernice Summerfield here is amazing, and she really does. Lisa Bauman carries the entire box set, and you can tell why she got loads of spin-offs by herself, and now she's kind of like going back with herself, Dr. Ace. So, yeah, it's a very nice box set for her character especially, but once again, it's just that ending that's going to make me give it an 8 overall, I think. Maybe a 7.5. Yeah, 7.5. So, yeah, there is quite a bit of fun to be had with these stories individually, but overall, A Triumph of Sutekh isn't the best box set, I would say. So then, that is all I have to say about this, really. Stay tuned later today for the review of The Sun Makers, where I'll also talk about all that big finish news that came out yesterday. Thank you for watching, everyone, and I will see you all next time. Bye, everyone.
Why do you still run? There is nothing more that you can do. Return to me. I will allow you the gift of seeing my rebirth before you die.